Okay, you can bring them. Just so that we start on time, so that we can. It is my great pleasure to welcome you for the third day of the conference. I hope you enjoyed the dinner yesterday. For those who missed it, I think you missed a lot. But I hope you will enjoy next year's as well. This is annual conference, so we hope that you will enjoy next year as well. Also, I would like to welcome you to this third day of invited talks and plenary talks where we have it every day in the morning session. Today's session, we have very good talks from industry and academia and industry. And it is my great pleasure to welcome Professor Pierluigi Siano. He received his master's and master degree in electrical engineering and PhD degree in information and electrical engineering from the University of Salerno, Italy, in 2001 and 2006, respectively. He is associate professor of electrical energy engineering with the Department of Industrial Engineering, University of Salerno. In 2013, he received the Italian National Scientific Qualification as full professor in the competition sector related to electrical energy engineering. Dr. Siano is editor-in-chief of Intelligent Industrial Systems, Springer, is one of the good journals in Springer, and an associate editor of IEEE Transactions on Industrial Informatics, and also member of an editorial board of more than 30 international journals. We have a lot to talk about, but I will leave this to you to read it. And with this, I would like to welcome Dr. Hussein.
Thank you very much, Chairman. I am from the University of Salerno in Italy, in the south of Italy. It is one of the largest universities in Italy, and this one was ranked as the first one in the south of Italy in terms of research activities and teaching and other indexes. The structure of the University of Salerno is that of a university campus like here, and it offers many services for teaching research to students, but also for students' life, such as the canteen, the swimming pool we have. And Salerno is also close to many beautiful touristic places, such as the Amalfi Coast, Sorrento, and so on. Today, I will talk about demand response, motivation capabilities, and key drivers. I will show the results of a pilot demand response project in Italy and data I coordinated in the last years. Then I will give some new ideas, speaking about some developing research activities on demand response that we are carrying out at the University of Salerno. Then I will conclude with some key challenges for demand response. As known, objective of demand response is that of competing as much as possible with generation, because we want to control demand as much as possible as generation, because it is cheaper. Demand response allows load curtailment in response to changes in price of electricity over time, or to incentive payments designed to induce lower electricity use at times of high wholesale market prices, or when the system reliability is put at risk. The main drivers for demand response implementations are environmental concerns, reliability, smart grid technologies, advent of energy management service providers, and policy incentives. As known, the smart grid applications are crucial in developing demand response by providing real-time data to producers and consumers, by using advanced metering solutions, and by deployment of appropriate technologies, devices and services to access and influence energy users' information, smart appliances, and in the direction of renewable energy. Also, combined with digital intelligence and real-time communications are able to improve the control of the transmission and the distribution needs. The project I coordinated in the last years is a pilot industrial research project named the System for Energy Savings with Integration of Air Conditioning. It was funded by the Italian Ministry of Economic Development and carried out with Bibicino, that is one of the most important industries in the field in Italy, and other Italian universities. I was coordinator and the principal investigator for this project for the University of Salerno from 2010 to 2014. Among other activities at the University of Salerno, we designed and implemented an energy management system, as shown here, that receives some inputs, such as information related to supply from the grid, to supply of energy from the grid, from storage systems, from local sources, such as renewable sources, and also it receives other information related to environmental parameters, user requirements, type of energy, available components, contract constraints, and also messages from a distribution network operator in the case that it is required. And this energy management system is able to provide energy management of loads and conditioning units, storages, local generation units, according to the user preferences. The output are, in fact, the command signals used for the control of thermal and electrical loads, and also messages that can be sent to the user. The system, the energy management system, may switch energy sources from the public grid to local generators or a battery, and the utility or service provider sends price or event messages to all houses over a home area network, such as the internet. These signals enter the house through a residential gateway or energy service interface that also serves as a line of demarcation between the utility and homeowner equipment. The system ensures the power supply and performs detachment or control of electrical loads based on given priorities and according to different control functions that may be selected by the user. In particular, we can control the air conditioning system, that is a controllable load, and some shiftable loads, such as the dishwasher washing machine. Among these the control functions that we have developed and that can be chosen by the user, we have the first one is the economy function. The economy function determines each period the best electrical load configuration to reduce the energy cost, also considering the user requirements and constraints. It is based on a time of use tariff that we have in Italy, that is based on two different costs, peak and off-peak, during peak and off-peak hours. According to this tariff for energy, we also try to move shiftable loads to the off-peak tariff period. The control of the temperature set point or the air conditioning is made in order to modify the temperature set point during the peak tariff period in order to reduce the cost of energy, also according to the user constraints, and also during the off-peak tariff period, the temperature can be controlled, but only when the power consumption exceeds the available power, including that from local sources. This is for improving the continuity of supply. We have another function that is the emergency function that is automatically selected by the system after a failure in the distribution supply. In this case, the electrical supply is provided by local generation, such as photovoltaic, wind, and so on, and by an electrical energy source storage system. Another function is the energy function that aims at ensuring even electrical energy consumption or economic expense in a prefixed period of time. This is based on the typical tariff that we had in Italy in the last years, according to which a user should pay a given amount of money only if its energy consumption is inside a given range. So, in this case, the system sends messages to the user informing it about the daily average consumption, the elevated consumption to achieve the prefixed target in terms of energy or cost. Another function is the thermal storage function that changes the temperature set point of the air conditioning in order to allow an anticipated cooling or heating in each controlled zone, also on the basis of local generation. Other functions are the power function. It is selected so that the absorbed active power is limited by a prefixed threshold value and may allow users receiving an economic benefit from distribution system operator. The net service function allows the distribution system operator controlling some selected loads in order to achieve benefits for the grid, while the end user will receive a premium for the service it offers to the DSO to improve the network reliability. At the end, we have the comfort function that is selected when the user is willing to assure its maximum comfort. He does not want to change the temperature set point or to move the shiftable loads, but this is made only in the case that the maximum available active power is exceeded. All these control functions have been implemented in a simulation tool named TDOS, which is also able to reproduce different house environments by varying the type and nominal power of electrical loads, the thermal characteristics of the building, the type and the technical characteristics of an air conditioning system, the presence and absence of inhabitants. Here we can see a mask of the software in which we can select some electrical loads with their nominal power and so on. And another mask is this for the calculation of the primary energy requirements, and this other mask show the results in terms of economic savings. The software is based on Monte Carlo simulation for this extraction process of the daily power profile of the house, starting from the knowledge of some social and economic factors. These control functions have been implemented on the basis of a state machine approach and developed in state flow of MATLAB. Then this software developed in state flow has been translated in a low level language to be implemented on the hard-headed processor, microprocessor, and this has been tested in real apartments, in real cases. Also, in order to carry out experimental results, a new device, that is an infrared interface, has been introduced. This is able to control the temperature set point of the air conditioning system by sending infrared commands. Instead of using the classical telecommand, this interface is directly connected to the field bus and is manageable directly by the energy management system. Experimental tests have been performed on two real apartments and compared with simulation results in order to validate the models and implement the functions. We have a percentage deviation from simulation results of 3-4%, and by implementing the economy function, a mean percentage annual cost reduction in the range of 5-10%. Depending on the efficiency class of the house from varying from A to G, can be achieved. For example, the fish site is located in Cantù near Comos Lake. It's a cottage of 160 square meters with energy performance class B. We have installed power capacity of 6 kilowatt with 6 kilowatt rated power photovoltaic system and controlled air conditioning system. In this case, the thermal storage function exploits the excess electrical energy generated by the photovoltaic system for thermal storage by increasing the power consumption of the air conditioning system for an anticipated cooling of the involved zone. Here we can see the experimental results of 7th of August 2015, in which we can see the activation of the thermal storage function due to an excess of production from the photovoltaic system. In this case, the energy not consumed exceeds the set the threshold that is 1 kilowatt. And we have, according a change of the temperature set point that we can see here, from 30 degree to 24 degree, and an increase of the energy consumption for the air condition. This study can be found in some articles, journals, and conferences. That if you are interested, you can contact me by email. I can send you. Now I will talk about some developing research activities. In particular, the idea is that of considering real-time nodal prices, distribution of local marginal prices, at the distribution level instead of the previous mentioned time of use tariff that is based only on two tariffs, peak and off-peak, and is not able to consider the distribution system constraints and power losses. The proposed approach introduces the nodal prices at the distribution level in a distribution energy market, as happens for example in the micro grid. Distribution location and marginal prices are based on three cost components: energy costs, congestions, and power losses. So they can take into account also the state of the distribution network. The developed probabilistic methodologies, this methodology, the uncertainties related to the stochastic variations of the involved variables are modeled by using Monte Carlo simulation. In this case, transactive controllers are designed to control air conditioning units and some shiftable loads, and to make bids on the distribution electricity market in response to distribution location and marginal prices and according end user requirements. In particular, temperature set point of the air conditioning and its maximum allowable variations are considered, and for shiftable loads, the desired operating period is taken into account. The architecture is shown in this figure. We have a demand response aggregator that, according to the signals that receives from the transactive controllers, makes the bids in the distribution market and gives feedback signals that are bid acceptance or rejection. For example, for air conditioning units, the bid quantity is computed based on the required energy to achieve the desired indoor temperature. We have a thermal model of the apartment. The bid price is instead computed on the basis of the mean of distribution location and marginal prices at the given bus in the previous 24 hours and on the basis of the indoor temperature distance from the set point. The air conditioning unit is switched on during the subsequent time slot only if the bid is accepted. A similar approach is adopted also for shiftable loads, whose bid prices are determined instead on the basis of a price forecast and of a prediction error on it. The bid price increases with time, also according to the appearance working time interval allowed by the user. As regards with the distribution acquisition market, in this market, demand response aggregators and distributed generators owners submit active power bids and offers to the distribution system acquisition market in the form of blocks for each time slot. The distribution system operator carries out a real-time intraday optimization every 15 minutes and carry out an optimization, the maximization of the so-called social welfare, in particular the market clearing quantity and prices. The prices are different at each bus, and they are the distribution location of marginal prices, are determined by maximizing the social welfare, considering the intertemporal constraints. Many simulation results have been carried out in order to test this method. In particular, we consider it an 84 bus network, 11.4 kilovolt radar distribution system in which we have three diesel generators, costly diesel generators, and 29 dispatchable loads that can be in the market. In particular, we have two 20 megavolt ampere transformers, thermal limits of the lines vary between 100 and 50 and 260 ampere. We consider the voltage limits between 10%. As regards with bus loads, we have both fixed and dispatchable loads. At each bus we have 120 residential loads. Of these, I told 29 buses are with dispatchable loads. These generators are considered to be located at the buses 53, 69, and 83, and we have groups of four, or 660 kilowatt. And the bid price of these generators is 160 euro per megawatt hour. The thermal characteristics of the houses are considering transmittances and thickness of walls, roof, floor, and so on. Time series have been collected for a wind period in south of Italy. And as regards with the user air conditioning comfort settings, we considering an average set point of 20 degrees with allowed variation of plus minus 2 degrees. We have in each house washing machine, dishwasher, and the results show, in this case, an average percentage of cost saving for a house, considering all the 29 dispatchable loads involved in a demand response program, a cost saving range between 10 and 30%, with most values concentrated between 15 and 25%. But this is a mean value, an average value. If we look instead at the savings at each bus of the network, we have different cost savings. In particular, we also carried out simulations by considering a different percentage of customers' involvement, varying from 25%, 50%, and 100%. We can say that in all cases, we have cost savings that are higher than 10%. But these cost savings are higher in the case of buses connected at feeder G or feeder M, for example, because in the case without demand response, we have congestions on some lines. In particular, we have congestions on this line 47, 48, and M 77. And these congestions can be alleviated by demand response, and for this reason we have higher cost savings in case of feeder G and feeder M. By observing these results, we can also say that the cost savings tends largely to increase with the reduction of customers' involvement in the demand response program. This is because the transactive controller of the air conditioning unit operates in such a way to decrease the temperature set point, we are in winter, to its lower bound when the prices are high due to congestions and expensive electrical power from these generators. This is more frequent when the customer's involvement is equal to 25%, and it causes higher average daily energy savings. We can also say that cost savings for feeder G. Cost savings for 100% of customers' involvement are lower than those considering 50% of customers' involvement. This is due to the simultaneous displacement of many shiftable loads to hours characterized by lower price forecast that determines the peak rebound effect and the consequent generation from costly diesel generators that increases the distribution local marginal prices. While the cost savings tend largely to increase with the reduction of customers' involvement in general, this is not true for the case of a feeder G. If we consider, for example, the percentage involvement of customers over 25%. As in this case, this percentage of involvement is not able to alleviate congestions on the feeder G in most cases. And for this reason, we have lower cost savings in this case. These are some results of variables during a winter day considered in the Monte Carlo simulation. At bus 52, we can see the distribution location of marginal prices without demand response, with demand response. We can see that with the demand response, most cases we can alleviate congestions. And this is for an involvement of 50% of customers. Instead, with an involvement of 25% of customers involvement, we can see that congestions cannot be removed in most cases, and the temperature set point is decreased to in correspondence of high prices. The temperature set point is decreased to its lower value, and for this reason we have energy savings in this case. We can say that this method is able to guarantee a percentage of cost savings always higher than 10%, both in the case with and without congestion on the distribution network. We also made other simulation without congestion. The transactive controllers generally, however, reducing the peak of the load curve. The adoption of distribution locational marginal prices in the real-time electrical energy market can in most cases prevent congestions. This method enables a case-by-case detailed analysis that is required in general to evaluate cost savings. This work has been submitted to applied energies and is actually under review. Now I will give some key challenges for my response. So, we can say that there is the need to establish reliable control strategies and market frameworks so that the demand response resource can be optimized. Due to the lack of experience, it is still needed to employ extensive assumptions when modeling and evaluating this resource. Reacting to a crisis, demand response loads to loads which at the same low price period, causing the peak rebound, which can be in most cases coupled with real-time transaction between customers and suppliers. If the demand response is limited, the system benefits may not be sufficient to cover the cost of the control and communication infrastructure for distribution system operator. Moreover, if the differentials in real-time prices vary over only a small range, the savings for customers may not be sufficient to induce investments in demand response programs, as customers may not be able to recoup the cost for installation or justify the burden of responding to prices. I will finish my presentation. I would remind you that we will organize a special issue on the Journal of Intelligent Industrial Systems, Springer, based on the papers accepted and presented during this conference. Also, if you have other recent research that you want to submit, you are very welcome. And thank you very much.
It's a wonderful presentation, and I think it's timely where it has the concept of optimization and also probabilistic approach. I'm very pleased to see such approach actually. Anyways, would you like to have any question? Yes, please.
Okay, what happens when all consumers behave the same way to save money? Don't you get then only a shift of the load? We all are waiting for low cost of energy till 10 o'clock in the evening, and then all consumers start at 10 o'clock.
Yes.
Then you will get the shift of the congestion.
Yes, yes. This is a general problem and key challenges when applying demand response programs. As we can also see from some simulation results, we have that most of the shiftable loads in this case are moved to the low prices periods, and this creates the so-called rebound effect. This effect can be, however, compensated by a transactive controller. The transactive controller, for example, for the controlling the air conditioning system, is able to dynamically change every 15 minutes its offer, and this can alleviate this problem, as shown by this simulation result. Thank you very much.
This is very interesting. Any other question? Okay, thank you very much. I'd like to hand on Dr. Petrich.
Don't skip.
Sorry. Don't skip.
Okay, I think we are on time.
So let me prepare for the second presentation.
It is my great pleasure to welcome the second presentation for today's session, Mr. Sass Perez. And we are pleased to have industrial view, same as yesterday. Yesterday we got also industrial view from